Grapes of Wrath is perhaps one of the greatest books ever written. Well, today, in the Katie Brown Workshop kitchen, we wanted to get a little bit inspired by the title and have some fun with it. So we've created fantastic grape salad that has a bit, well, of a wrath to it. It's got a little bit of spice, but it is so, so delicious. And the first thing I'm gonna do is I've taken a whole bundle of red and white grapes and I've just sliced them right in half. And I want to heat them up a little bit. And the best way to do that is to take about a tablespoon to a tablespoon and a half of butter, put it in a saucepan that's nice and hot, and let that butter just get melted along the bottom of that pan. And I'm just going to cook up the grapes right in the butter mixture. But to give it that little bit of wrath or that little bit of bite, I am going to take about a half of a teaspoon of cayenne pepper and just mix that right in or toast that right in with your butter. And then it's time to take your grapes and just heat them up ever so slightly. We kind of liked using a combination of the red and the white grapes. I think it's very, very beautiful. Growing up, my mom used to make us grape salads all the time. It was one of the only fruits that my sisters and my brother and I really liked to eat. It reminds me of home, and I'm always trying to think of new ways to cook it up. And this one was kind of fun to just give it a little bit of spice. The first time we tested it here at the workshop, we thought, okay, that's good, but it's missing something. And we thought, it's missing that wrath. It needs a little bit of cayenne pepper. And once you toss that all up, you're ready to add in a few more ingredients. And you want to take it right off the heat then. And I am just going to take about a cup of chopped walnuts for a little bit of an added crunch to my salad, and about half a cup of blue cheese crumbled right in there. And just kind of give it a good mixture. And you'll see, because those grapes are a little bit roasted and toasted, that blue cheese is just gonna kind of melt right in there and act as almost a dressing for this grape salad. And you might want to take it at this point and just transfer it into a bigger bowl. It's going to make it a little less hot because it's not actually the bowl that you cooked it up with. And just toss it ever so slightly. And if you see that your blue cheese is starting to clump up, just with that wooden spoon, break it up, because you really want that cheese to be evenly distributed throughout your salad. Good toss. Now, just for a little bit of color and a little bit more flavor, I'm gonna take a chopped scallion. Oh, that smells fantastic. And I'm just gonna toss that right in there with my grapes, with my blue cheese, and with those crunchy walnuts. Oh, I'm gonna have to give it a little bit of a taste and just make sure that it's everything I think it should be. Mmm. Oh, I love it. I love the combo of those warm grapes with that hint of heat, which I like to refer to as my wrath for my Grapes of Wrath salad.